Good morning to all my law students. The aim of this short video clip is to help you prepare for the flipped learning activity that you'll be required to deliver next week. I've already given you the reading to do from the A-level law textbook. Most of you feel comfortable just reading the information and hopefully understanding it. But this is an alternative to those who might want to watch this quick video. Now, the central theme based on the reading is for you to think about what we mean by negligent liability, and when you read the book it will be what the courts need to do to determine if somebody's done something wrong in terms of negligent behaviour. Now, another important thing you need to think about is obviously the definition of negligence. Think about your own definition, giving basic examples. But then higher learners might be able to find a legal definition of negligence and also a suitable case. The case you might want to think about would be Blyth and Birmingham Waterworks and the statement by Baron Alderson in relation to the legal definition of negligence. Now, once you've identified what the definition of negligence is, and I'll ask you to contribute in lesson, think about the seminal case in the tort of negligence, because the whole point of this short activity is to help you identify or be able to explain when the courts are able to suggest confidently that somebody has committed a negligent act and therefore breached their duty of care. So think about the seminal case, Donoghue and Stevenson, and also identify what Lord Atkin talks about when he refers to the neighbour principle. In addition to that, there is a more up-to-date case, Caparo and Dickman in 1990. There are three key things that you need to think about. So there are three legal principles from the case of Caparo and Dickman, and they are the three things that the courts use to determine if somebody has broken their duty of care owed to another person. So please look out for those details in Caparo and Dickman. Now, once you've done that, have a look at the meaning of foreseeability of harm linked to the case of Kent and Griffiths. So when we talk about foreseeability of harm, what does that mean? Have a little read about that. In addition to that, proximity is an essential key in terms of determining whether somebody's broken their duty of care. So think about the case of Borhill and Young and also the case of McLaughlin and O'Brien. Now, apart from those cases, have a look at the case of Hill and Chief Constable of West Yorkshire, and the more up-to-date case which changes the legal principle or improves the legal principle in the case of Robinson and Chief Constable of West Yorkshire. Now, once you've done all that, next week when we meet, I'll be asking you to explain very briefly how the courts determine if somebody has committed a negligent act or if somebody's broken their duty of care. Please, to end the flipped learning activity, do make sure you identify any questions that you don't understand. If there's a case you're not sure about, please list that on the flipped learning mat, which is a sheet of paper with the information on, and we will be able to discuss that during the lesson. Thank you very much for watching this video, and I shall see you all next week. Thank you.